guys, it's Katie the Messy Soaper, and I just want to wish you all a happy fucking 4th of July. And for those of you who do not know what that means, well, where have you been? Last year and every season, Rustic Escentuals, the amazing Amy, owner of Rustic Escentuals, send me their line, their fragrance oil for that season. And I got, let me tell you guys, I have a treat for you all. I just got a package today. So this is the Rustic Escentuals Fukin Happy 4th of July. And I call it Happy 4th of July for those who don't know, because it's like Christmas in July. I get the most amazing fragrances, and they're the holiday line. So that gives you guys time to get over there and pick up some of these amazing fragrances. You will not be disappointed. I am just blown away by how amazing some of these fragrances smell. Honestly, all of them. So, and I did get a few colorants as well. She allowed me to pick out a few colorants and a few fragrances that I wanted. So I just went on their website, and I'm going to leave all the information in the section below. And stay tuned, watch the whole video, because there's something very, very cool that Rustic Essential is doing as well. And I'm going to link that in the section below, but I'll tell you about it first. So be sure you watch the whole video, because you don't want to miss out on anything, because I got some amazing fragrances. So that's enough of looking at my mug, and I'm going to get to showing you the fragrances that I got. I'm telling you guys, ooh, love. Okay, see you in a second.
All right, guys, I am not going to keep you guys waiting. I told you that this fragrance haul is amazing, most definitely. So I'm going to start with the fragrance oils that I was allowed to pick, because I want to save the best for last, which they're all amazing, but you definitely want to get their holiday line. These are not on their website today. Today is July 1st. Jeez, I lost a month. July 1st. So check back in a couple of days and everything should be there. Yeah, so what I did get was Essence of Jesus. And I was really, really intrigued about this fragrance oil because the notes on it. I don't have the information in front of me. Sorry, I should have been more prepared. But I'm going to smell them and tell you guys what I think. So this one is most definitely, it could be masculine or feminine. It has very woodsy notes in it, and I would say woodsy and musky. Yeah, that's the best way I can describe it. And it'll make, I mean, like a beautiful men's bar of soap, a unisex bar of soap. You can also make, like, if you do, you guys do beard balms and all that stuff for men, most definitely can do that as well. This one I most definitely like. I think I'm gonna make a men's soap out of this one here. And then I got some white nectarine, which I remember the way this one smelled, because this one smelled amazing. It, like, you remember, like, I'm trying to figure out the best way I can explain it. Like, if you had, like, the canned peaches, like, the syrup that's in it, to me, it smells very, very good. It has a hint of that. It's not that full fragrance, but it does have a hint of that. And I love nectarines, and this smells so, so gosh darn good. So, for those of you who like the fruity fragrances, this is most definitely a good one to pick out. It's not very, like, too strong. It's just a sweet, soft nectarine fragrance. I really, really, really do like this one. Yeah, it does have like a bit of that type of note to it, like the peach juice, but because I want to say nectar, but I haven't been like around flowers or telling bees, hey, come here, let me smell the nectar you just sucked out of that flower, right? So anyway, it does smell amazing. So I got neroli because I'm a fan of neroli, and neroli is pretty strong by itself, but I got neroli because I do want to mix it with some other fragrances, just kind of play around a little bit and see what I can come up with. Neroli is very, very popular also in Lush Cosmetics. They use neroli blend in a lot of their fragrances, so that's what made, in a lot of their products, so that's what made me want to try it. So I don't know what I'm going to come up with, but I am going to play around with it a little bit. So, most definitely my suggestion, and Amy suggested as well, that you mix this with something, or not mix it, I said mix it, she said use, a lower amount in your per pound of oil, in your soap, or your cosmetics. Yeah, this one is very, very heady. Neroli has its own fragrance, it's very hard to explain, but I'm a big fan of neroli, so for those of you who know what neroli is, you'll love this, because it smells dead on to the real thing. even though it's a fragrance oil. So for those who don't, it's kind of hard to explain. You might want to go and read the notes on that. So also I got lemon curd, which this this smells just like lemon head candy to me. Oh yeah, it just, it's not that pot, that pledge, that lemon pledge or anything like that. It smells just like the lemon head candy that we pretty much all of us has had when we're children, have had when we're children. So yeah, if you like lemon, most definitely get you some lemon curd. I am like in love with this one right now. Seriously in love with kimono flower. Oh guys, you gotta get some. Okay, I picked this because it just seemed like it would smell good, and it smells amazing. It's just, ooh, it's sweet, and it's fresh, and it's floral. It's just a amazing blend of awesome sauce. That's what it is. Oh, it's very feminine. I'm telling you, very, very feminine. I would totes my goats wear this as a perfume. I think I got an idea for this soap already, for this fragrance already, but... oh, love, love, love. Most definitely get you some of this. Even if you're not a floral person, I think you would enjoy this because it's not very, very strong. It's just a very soft, feminine fragrance. When I say it's not strong, I don't mean that the scent is weak. I mean that it's just not one of those overpowering, too strong fragrances. So, I think everybody should try kimono flower. I just do, okay? And then I got winter linen because anything that's linen is just... or sheets, or just that clean, fresh smell, I'm all for it. So I already knew I was gonna like this even before I smelled it, and I most definitely am not disappointed. It smells just like, I don't know if this makes any sense. I like to hang my clothing on the line in the summer, and you know that really fresh smell you get in your clothing when they hang out in the sun and air dry. That's what this reminds me of. But this is definitely amazeballs, okay? And I also pick Japanese pear and ginseng because I've been wanting a pear fragrance. So when I saw that it was Japanese pear and ginseng, I had to get it. Now I will say on this one, you can, if you know what ginseng smells like, you can smell that note. Most definitely smell that note of ginseng in it. And, ginseng is a little bit, I want to say maybe tart, and it does smell like pear as well. It's very fresh. Yeah, that's the word to use. It's a very, very fresh smell. So loving this one as well. I'm so glad I didn't bomb something. But honestly, I don't even think that Rustic Essential has anything that would be considered a bomb. Everything they have is just great, let me tell you. So I had placed an order from them a couple of months ago, and they sent me a sample of this flannel sheets, and I fell in love with it. I told you, like, anything that sheets or linens or blankets or comforters, whatever, that fragrance, I just love that smell. So I definitely had to get a bottle of this. This one is, again, like the winter linen. It's very fresh. It's fresh, but very cozy, if that makes any sense. It just makes you, honestly, it makes you want to wrap up in a blanket. It really does. And, like, sit in front of a fire. Oh, I'm in love with that. It smells, I can't even explain how great it smells, okay? Just take my word for it. And then I got pink lilac and willow. I just felt like this was going to be a good one. I just did because, I don't know. I wanted to try it. It just seemed very intriguing. That's one thing about Rustic Essentials, fragrances, all of them, just, they're intriguing because of their blends. You just don't find too many companies that have blends like Rustic Essentials. So that's why you need to most definitely get over there. If you're looking for something different, or if you are the kind of person like I used to be that would mix fragrances, you don't have to do that because they've done it all for you, most definitely. So that's why I picked this one. And I was looking because I knew that was one that I asked for. I just had to be sure. Yeah, but this pink lilac and willow. Pink. Oh, it just... It smells like a real fucking lilac, y'all. I mean, just like a real lilac. Oh, smudge. I have makeup. I got makeup on the cap. Let's turn it that way. But anywho, you know what? I washed my hands, so I don't know where the makeup came from. But anyway, oh wow, I just got makeup all over the caps of all of these. So please forgive if you do see a smudge on the caps. But anyway, it's not about my makeup and smudgy fingers. I must have rubbed my face. But this pink willow, pink lilac and willow, it is just like, it smells, I mean, dead on to lilac. If you like lilac, but it's like lilac with a twist. It's like, I don't know, because I don't know what willow smells like exactly, but you can smell that there's another note in there. But it is very girly. It is very feminine. It is very just, oh, it's very floral. So if you are a floral person, most definitely get you some pink lilac and willow. You won't be disappointed. Okay, so those are the ones that I picked out. And then she asked me, were there any colorants that I wanted? And I said, of course, I do. I just love them so much. They treat me so well. I am just, and this is no joke, I am just so blessed. It's just unbelievable how blessed I am to know Amy of Rustic Escentuals and be able to be a tester for Rustic Escentuals. I just cannot thank them enough because they have me spoiled rotten. Absolutely. And I just... thank you guys so much, every last one of you at Rustic Escentuals. And guys, if you haven't checked out their videos, they do have a YouTube channel. Be sure to check out their YouTube channel because it is so cool to see their everyday inner workings in Rustic Escentuals. You'll get to see some videos of that and then packing orders. And I mean, it's just amazing. And the warehouse is huge. So this is not some little mom and pop shop. This is a huge warehouse filled with fragrances that will make you lose your mind and all of your money. So I got some blushed pink mica here, and isn't that purry? I really wanted just like a very, very soft pink, so that's why I picked this one. And I also got some sparkling gold mica. The last one I had from them was 24 karat gold, and I just love these little bitty spoons. So if you like need a pinch of mica, there you go, and they're affixed to all the tops when you get them. So this is sparkling gold mica. If I can clear that up, there we go. And I wanted to see how this one was compared to the 24 karat, because I was madly in love with the 24 karat. And this one is just like a wee bit of a darker hue. I'm trying to catch the light because this is a ring light. But yeah, it's just a wee bit of a darker hue than the 24 karat mica. So, and you can see a little bit better on the lid. It's not as dark as it looks in the container. So it is gold. I really, really do like it, most definitely. And I think I inhaled some. Because my nose is feeling a little bit itchy. But anywho, if I sneeze, forgive me. So, I also got some Cornflower Celebration mica. And you, as you guys know, for those of you who are always here, I use all of Rustic Essentials colors as well as their fragrance oils. So anytime you see me use their fragrances, even if I don't mention it, their colors are most definitely Rustic Essentials that I am putting in my soaps. I'm talking so fast because I'm excited, y'all. So the Cornflower Celebration mica is like this really, really cool blue. I've not seen a blue like this before. I kind of don't know how to explain the color of it. It's almost like a denim, I don't know, maybe a lighter color denim. I do really, really like this, and that's why I picked it, because I didn't have a blue like that. And I also got another blue, which is Denim Strut, and I just love the name. It's like super fabbly-ably. That's one reason why I picked it. But I saved this one for last because I wanted to show you guys. I love this blue. This blue is gorgeous. You see that? You see how pretty that blue is? Oh, I cannot wait to soap this. I already have an idea for this. So that's why I picked these micas. So if you're looking for a company that has tried and true micas, most definitely get them from Rustic Essentuals, because I've never, not a single time, had color morphing. Not one time since I've been using their micas. So that's something you most definitely don't have to worry about. So now we're going to move on, because if you do make candles or wax tarts or any of that, you can stop at Rustic Essentuals as well, because they do sell candle fragrances. So that's what these are. And I keep bumping the camera because my arms are behind it and this ring light is huge. So I'm going to stick those in the front. And it just makes me a little bit sad. Because last year she gave me one, I think it was a plum fragrance as well. And it was candle. Like, gosh darn it, I wish that it was like for soap, because I do like plum. So this one is plum tart, and again, it's for candle. It's not for Bath and Body, just for candle. So for those of you, like I said, that makes candles and wax melts and all of those things, or room fresheners or incense, most definitely you can get all your fragrances right here at Rustic Essentials as well. Not here, but there. So this tart plum or plum tart is, it is very plummy and it is tart. It's just like the name, and I just love it. This is just one of those ones that make you want to kind of drink it. And I know I say that a lot about certain fragrances that I smell from them, but they do just have fragrances that make you want to drink them. So be sure to keep them out of reach of little hands. I also got some sugar frosted plum as well. And I like this one too. I told you guys, I'm just a plum fan, most definitely. That one's just, it's very soft, and it's very, it's like one of those soothing fragrances. The tart plum is very tart, and this one is on the softer side. It's sweet. It smells like a sweet. Let's just go with that. And again, when I say soft, I don't mean like a weak fragrance, but it's a more, it's not as tart as this or potent as this. It's just a gentle fragrance. And I explained this clearly. Okay. But you would like it most definitely. It's more on the sweet side. And then I do have a Celebrate Christmas type. And Celebrate Christmas type. I thought I said Celebrating Christmas type. So this one is very Christmassy, most definitely. So if you need to get your holiday fragrance oils, run and get you some of this. Just smelling it just makes you instantly think of Christmas trees and bulbs and lights and Christmas presents. It just puts you right in the Christmas mood. It's on the spicy side. It's like a spicy and kind of a mixture of a sweet and a piney. So if you're into those holiday fragrances, this is most definitely one that you would love, and your house will smell just amazeballs, okay? And then we have Spice Autumn Wreath right here. Let me smell this one, because I don't remember, because of course when I got all these, I ripped open the package like a mad person and smelled all of them. But I don't remember all the notes, so that's why I come to you guys on camera and smell them. This one again is, oh, I really like that one. Yeah, I like that one a lot. This one, it smells like autumn. It has a spicy note, and I'm not a big fan of spicy fragrances normally, but this one is, it's just like a really pleasant spicy fragrance. But it does most definitely put you in the mind of curling up in front of a fireplace with a warm blanket. It is very fall like fragrance, most definitely puts you in the mood for that. Now, I have Holiday Spice balsam. And I will say, this is not one of my favorites. I think this is the first time ever in the history of me doing testing for Rustic Essential that I've had one that I said, well, this is not for me. But it's not to say that it's not for others, because Gabe loves it, okay? He's really into the spicy, the piney, you know, that type of fragrance. So, if you like that type of fragrance, yeah, this one is very strong. It has a very strong pine scent to it, so if you're really into that, it smells like a pine tree and a wreath, like a real wreath. And I know that's kind of like the same thing, but yeah, if you're really into the piney type fragrances, you're gonna love this one. And your house will smell just like you cut down a fresh pine tree. So that might be for those of you who really like the spicy type piney fragrances. I'm just not that kind of girl. I'm more on the sweet and the musky type of fragrances, oddly enough, because I love this one here. But yeah, if you're into the pine trees and the more spicier notes, definitely get you some of that. Okay, so now, here comes the fun. I mean, that was amazeballs right there, but these right here, and I'm not going to move them over all together, I'll just move over one by one. These are the holiday fragrances of 2016, fall and Christmas, and holiday. I was going to say Thanksgiving, but let's just say holiday. So you most definitely want to keep your eye out and head over there when they get them listed, because you're going to want these. I'm telling you, you are going to want these for sure. And the candle fragrances that I showed you are a part of their holiday line as well. So you can get those. If you go right now, because again, because I said today is July the 1st, they're not listed right now, but they most definitely will be. Okay, so solar power. What do you think what comes to mind? What notes come to mind when you think solar power? I had no clue, because she kind of sent me a list last night before my fragrances got here, telling me what I was getting. And I'm just like, I can't even imagine that one. But let me tell you guys, love, okay? Love in a bottle, most definitely. I am so doing a dude soap out of this one because it smells, it's very... Actually, you know what? No, let me take that back. I was thinking this one was one of the guy soaps I was going to do, but oddly enough, this solar power is very sweet. Yeah, it is very sweet. It's just, you wouldn't even get, you know, the name. You wouldn't come up with sweet, but it's like a sweet girly fragrance. Really, it is. I think, yeah, I got this mixed up with something else, but this is a very girly fragrance, and I do like it a lot. It is just yummy smelling. It's more of the sweet, almost kind of candy, or like a drink, like a sweet drink. So love that one, most definitely. So if you like the sweet type fragrances, solar power, most definitely go and get that. Then we have autumn rain. Let's smell this one. Yeah, that is great. That is absolutely great. This one reminds me as well of like the linen, the fresh clean linen type fragrance. But it does have Rustic Essential is amazing when it comes to fragrance, and I'm not just saying that because I'm a tester for them. I'm saying that because honestly, I've not come across a company that just kind of nails the notes like that. It says autumn rain, and you do get hints. You know how like when it first rains, you get that fresh rain smell? It does have a hint of that in here. How they do it, I don't know, but I'm glad you did. This smells so gosh darn good, guys. And I know this video is going to be a bit lengthy, but it is worth it. And you guys need to stay from beginning to end, because you have to see and hear all of these, because you're going to want them. If you are a soap maker, you're going to want them. And I'm going to start soaping these puppies like right away. I'm not waiting until Christmas and fall and Thanksgiving. No, no, no. Because some of them just scream to be made. So you most definitely want to get this one. If you're into the clean and the like the fresh and the rain type scents, autumn rain, most definitely. I was pretty excited about this one as well. This is Cashmere Woods and Tonka Bean. Anything with Tonka Bean, love, okay? Loves it. So, I was just like, wow, I wonder what that would smell like. I knew it was going to be pretty. And it is definitely pretty, okay, guys? It smells like a very expensive perfume. And it's not like the... Yeah, it smells like a very high-end perfume. It's not like the sweet one. It's just one of those kind of perfumes that a person will walk by you, or if you go like down a hallway where someone's been, you're just like, wow, who smells that amazing? That's what this smells like. I am in love. It is very girly. It is very feminine. It is very sultry and sexy. So if you are into that type of fragrance, you want to get you some Cashmere Woods and Tonka Bean. Guys, super excited about that one. Okay, I got some silver, birch, and vetiver. Now this one I do remember, because I made the Hunter soap out of a fragrance that smells very similar to this, that was Rustic Essentials as well. Yeah, this reminds me so much of that, but it has just a slight different note. I wish I could remember off the top of my head what the fragrance oil I used for the Hunter soap that I made, but this one is very manly. And Wendy, if you're watching, I'm going to make this soap, but I know your hubby's going to love it, because the Hunter soap was one of her hubby's favorite, and this reminds me so much of that, but it just had a little twist to it. So it's the vetiver. It is most definitely the vetiver. It's very manly. It's very masculine. It's very musky, woodsy. It smells delish, okay? You're going to have your sexy man walking around, okay? And now, green pumpkin. When I saw that, I said, what in the world could that possibly smell like? I was really, like, curious about what this would smell like. But, guys, let me tell you. it is, this is one of those fragrances that you have to smell like two or three times, because you, every time you smell it, you pick up a different note. It's like definitely a green type of fragrance, like a leaf, and I'm picking up a little bit of, just a tad bit of apple notes and pumpkin, but not a spicy pumpkin. It is just one of those fragrances that's just like so complex, but it smells amazing. And again, like I said, guys, if you're looking for a company that has just mind-blowing combinations in their fragrances, then here you go. Rustic Escentuals, most definitely. Love this, okay? I'm definitely going to be getting some of that. Getting some of that. Oh, hello, I have it. Making some of that is what I meant to say. So this one is Hummingbird Nectar. And this was another that I was just like, wow, it does smell like what you imagine nectar smelling like. And it's something that I've smelled, some type of fruit or something that has a very, like a sweet nectar type smell to it. And this one is definitely dead on for that. It's, oh, yummy. That's the best way I can explain it, as yummy. It's rich and it's sweet and it's sticky in a good way. Oh, that just smells like, again, I want to turn it up and drink it, but don't, okay? I really, really do like that one. I mean, a whole lot, okay? And then, I'm just so gosh darn excited. Rustic Essential has just blown my socks off. That's probably why I'm not wearing any. But they have just, 2016 holiday, fall and winter, guys. I'm just speechless at how amazing these fragrances smell. This white velvet bowl, when I opened this, I just had to sit back for a second like, whoa. It's amazing. It is another one of those fragrances where it's just like very girly and very, not, no, let's not say girly. Let's say womanly. It smells like a very expensive perfume on a very rich woman who's very classy, who's classic. It is just amazeballs. Okay, I got it. I'm like, where is this makeup on these caps coming from? Because I keep sticking my nose on the cap. Because I'm like, I never washed my hands. So dumb. But anyway. yeah, this one is one you want to have. I don't care if you're a fruit or a floral or what have you. This is a very expensive smelling fragrance, just like the cashmere one. You gotta have it, okay? Want to make, some of these I'm most definitely gonna wear as perfumes. I'm just telling you that now. So they will be a little bit safe for moi. So we got some Stonehouse Reserve. And I don't remember how this will smell. Let's see. That one is very, the best way I can describe this one is outdoorsy. And it's just like, yeah, outdoorsy and wood type and just fresh. It just, I don't know. I don't know why this pops in my head. I think of Ireland when I smell this. Like, it's very fresh and very, you know, the green notes. If you like that type of fragrance, this most definitely will be a very, very good one for you. Men will love it. So now I'm going to do Amber Luminaire type. Yeah, that's Amber. Where is it? Embry. Luminaire type. And I don't remember what this one smells like either. Let me see. Oh, yeah. That smells good. That smells clean. That smells like something you would find in like a facial moisturizer, but high-end. All of these fragrances are like so high-end smelling. Or like something for your hair. It smells like a very good smelling expensive shampoo without the shampoo note, if that makes any sense. Because I've smelled some shampoo, you have shampoos that smell like fruit and this, you know, and candy and blah blah blah, but you have some when you buy the more higher end shampoos. When I was buying shampoo, which I do not now because I use myself to wash my hair, but anyway, I remember coming across some, and I'm just like, $30 a bottle? Yeah, why? And then you smell it, you're like, I can kind of see why, because it smells maize balls. So this is what that this fragrance reminds me of, most definitely. So if you like those type of fragrances that are clean and, yeah, very clean, but it kind of has like almost a perfume note to it as well, you're going to like that one. Now here's another one, white chocolate apple. I mean, seriously? I'm like, wow. Guys, I got a soap. I got a soap for my Christmas, because you guys know that I did my five gold apples and my the year before last. I don't remember, had the red apples on the top, but I'm already seeing what this soap is gonna look like. So you guys just have to wait and see. But it is. It is very apple-y, let me tell you. Very, very apple-y. You would think when you say chocolate, you would think a heavy chocolate smell, but it's not. Because, A, it's white chocolate. But it has a very, because white chocolate is very sweet. So it's an apple and sweet, and it's just yummy. I cannot wait to soap this one, guys. Cannot wait. Oh, yeah, I see apples in my future. So let's do White Woods. I don't remember this one, so let me see. Oh, yeah. Oh. Ooh. Oh. Okay, let me stop, because that doesn't sound right. this smells good. You think white woods, you think very woodsy and outdoors. Nope. It smells like, it smells like kind of like it has a note of caramel or something in it. It smells delicious. It smells like a bakery treat to me. That's just me. Everybody says the smell is different, but it smells very bakery-ish to me. It smells delicious, okay? Like it should be sitting in a scone somewhere waiting for me to eat it, okay? So, yeah, if you like that, I'm not getting woods, but like I said, everybody senses the smell is different. So get it just to find out. I think you're going to like this because I'm in love right now. I think I'm in love with all of these. And the only reason why I said the one that I didn't really care for is because it was very, very piney. And I'm just not a piney girl, but you can't go wrong. All of these, you just cannot go wrong. I'm going to lift the camera a little bit just like that. Okay. Yeah. That way you can kind of see everything. So now we got some Caramel Cafe, and yeah, when I smell this one, even before I smelled it, I said, I know I'm going to love it because I love coffee. I do. And I love caramel creamer and anything with caramel in it. And oh, that smells so good. Oh, that smells great. Oh, no. Boo-hoo. This is candle. I thought I separated all the candle. I thought I was about to make a seriously sticky sweet soap with this, but I'm telling you guys, for those of you who make wax tarts, and I need to get off my hiney and make some wax tarts, wax melts, because I do have the wax here. I just have it. My house needs to smell like this every single day of as long as I live here or wherever I live. Yeah, because it smells just that great. Oh, bummer, man. I thought this was for soap because I was totally about to do some magic, but I'm telling you, you gotta get it anyway, because anybody who burnt it, I don't care, it doesn't have to be for the holiday, it could be right now, it's you know, the beginning of summer. If you want your house to smell amaze balls like coffee, like a coffee cafe, like a caramel coffee cafe, then definitely get some of this. Yummy, yummy, yummy. Okay, so now we got some Snow Kiss sugar type, and I do like this one. Definitely do like this one. It's I don't know, again, like I said, when you some fragrances you smell, you're just like, I don't get that, but this reminds me, it puts you in a mindset of fresh fallen snow, but sweet. So that kind of hence the name. You can most definitely get those notes of how they came up with that name. Yeah, it's a light sweetness to a freshness, if that makes any sense. I do like this one, definitely. And I am going to save this one for winter just because I like the name. Yeah, I do like the name. But of course, it's not going to stay the same because I believe it's a type of some type of fragrance that's already out there. But yeah, I just feel like this is very fitting for the winter. It's so sweet. It's just yummy. So this is the one I was thinking when I said I was most definitely going to make it for a man, when it ended up being the very sweet one. I don't know where it's at. Yeah, the solar power. This is the one I was thinking of. Stainless steel. Yeah, because this is so sexy for a sexy dude. Yeah. So, Gabe, you're my sexy dude. So, you're going to get some of this, buddy. Yeah. Mm. It's like stainless steel. What do you think? I don't know what comes to mind. I think stainless steel, first mind goes to a refrigerator. But, this smells very beachy. Guys, it smells like clean, masculine, and beachy. Mm, yeah, yep, most definitely. And this can honestly be used for women's soap as well. For women that like that more muskier, beachy smell. And when I say musky and clean, it's kind of both of them. It's kind of hard to explain, but it most definitely is both of them. Gabe, yeah, you're getting some of this, dude. Because it smells really, really good. And I have one over here. Amy and I spoke about, I'm going to save two of them for the last one. So we're going to go to Tinsel Tree right here. And I do like this one, oddly enough. I'm just not big on like the Christmas tree type fragrances, but it's been a few in here that I'm like, yeah. Like I said, all of them I like except for the piney one. This one is, now see, this one has a note of pine. You can most definitely smell the note of pine, but there's a sweetness to it as well. And when I say sweet pine, you're just like, ooh. No, trust me when I say you will like this. If you're into the Christmassy, and it's not that spicy. There's a sweet note and there's a pine note that I really enjoy. Yeah, I do. I like this a lot. So, if you're looking for that sweetness and that piney and just that Christmas feel, Tinsel Tree, definitely got to get some of that. And then, now here's another one that's just like very intriguing. Pinecone and lime. Now, really? You like pinecone and lime? What does that smell like? But again, Rustic Essentials nailed it, okay? It's like, it's crazy because it's like pine and lime. But it's so refreshing. It is extremely refreshing. It's like you, again, this is one of those fragrances you have to smell a few times. Because once you get a little bit of pine, and then you get some lime. I mean, you can't explain it better than its actual name. You just can't. It is kind of cool. It reminds me of a Christmas tree on a beach. Just kind of puts you in that beachy feel as well. So, yeah, that's a very unusual blend, but I'm digging it, guys. Definitely digging it. Okay, so now we got some snow-covered pines. Let's see how we feel about that one. Mm. See, again, this one most definitely smells like pine. But it has a crisp note. Like a crisp note and almost a beachy note to it. So that is really funny that I said Christmas tree on a beach. This is what I'm kind of getting from that. I hope that the way I'm explaining these are kind of giving you guys a picture, but that's just what it smells like to me. But it is very, very pleasing. Definitely pleasing. Yeah, I like this a lot. Yep. I'm trying to think of other notes, but it does kind of put me of like a, it's like a beech wood and a pine. That's what I'm trying to say. Yeah, there we go. Let's just go with that. But it's, you'll like it. If you're into the piney, you will definitely like that one. So now, oh, wait, okay, I said there were two that I was going to save last. Nope, there's three. Guys, okay, if you guys ever heard of Archway Cookie, when I was a little girl, my mom used to always buy Archway Cookie. They were in, like, the package that were just, it was kind of like this and more narrow. And then it had a stack of cookies in one tray and a stack of cookies in another. And the cookies were like this. And they were lemon. They were iced lemon. This iced lemon cookie, I mean, dead on, guys. When I smelled this, I almost fell out my chair. I'm like, oh, it smells so good. Ow! That smells amazing. It just makes me happy because it takes me back to my childhood. I'm just like, guys, yummy, yummy. I would, if I knew it wouldn't put me in the hospital, I'd turn that whole bottle up and drink it whole. I'm telling you. But I'm not because I got a lot of soaping to do. And guys, I'm on a 2-week vacation from work. Yes! So there is going to be some crazy soapery going on around here. Okay, let me tell you. But yeah, that fragrance, it makes me happy. Can't you guys tell in the tone of my voice how happy I am about that? It just does. If you guys know what I'm talking about, please, for the ones of you who know what I'm talking about, comment below, because that was like my most favorite fucking cookie ever. So yeah, that one, if you know what it smells like, then you're gonna want some of this, definitely. So next we have, I don't even know which one to do first. I'm just gonna do them both. I'll show you both. When I saw the name of Earl Grey and apple, I'm like, say what? Because I love the smell of Earl Grey, and then you throw some apple in there, come on. And then Hipster is the one that Amy and I both said we love, and I am totally making a perfume out of Hipster. Two, what's left, it's going into the perfume from Moi. So let's go with the Earl Grey and apple first. And for those of you who don't know, Earl Grey is a tea. Anything with tea and I love. So this one is, I don't know, it reminds me of something very English, if that makes any sense. I guess I get that thought because, you know, a lot of people over in Europe and London and England, they drink a lot of tea. But it is very, it's just like this very classy and proper and crisp smell. You most definitely can smell the apple. And you don't get like that straight up just black tea smell. No, Earl tea has its very own unique fragrance. And I knew I was going to enjoy this one, and I most certainly do. But this one is going to be saved for the holiday, because to me it does smell like a holiday fragrance, but not your traditional holiday fragrance. So I am very excited to make this one, definitely. Love the way it smells, guys. Most definitely. Now let's talk about some Hipster, okay? Because I can sort of be a hipster, but not the annoying one with the corncob pipe and make you want to slap them out. No, not that hipster. But this fragrance, oh, guys, this is not for your man hipster. It is for your woman hipster, okay? Oh, then again, guys could pull this off, but I'm going to give this more towards women. It's like a perfume. It's so fresh and free, and you just smell, you smell like you look cool if you smell like this, okay? That's why I can explain it. You really just, I think if you wear this, even if you're not cool, if you wear this, you just instantly, bam, you're cool. I love this. It is light, but it's fresh, and it's kind of airy. It's just, it's good. That's the best thing I can say about it. It's just good. It's just good. It's just good. But love, okay? Definitely love this fragrance. So as you guys can see, I love them all. Yep. Mm-hmm. So I hope that you guys run over to Rustic Essentials and get you some of their new 2016 fall winter holiday fragrances, because you are going to be so happy that you did. You will not be disappointed. If you can afford to get every last one of these, then I suggest you do so. If you cannot, then you buy them 2-3 at a time, but they are most definitely worth having. And my cat, you need to chill out, dude, because I'm almost finished. Just a few minutes more, buddy. But yeah, guys, I'm telling you, go over to Rustic Essentials. And even if you go over and you haven't saw the fragrance listed yet, don't go nowhere. You need to hang out over there and just go through all of their fragrances, because they have some of the most unique, amazing fragrances ever. And again, I am not just saying that because I'm a tester for them. If I didn't like something, I'd tell you. I have no reason to lie. And they just perform well. And the scent retention is just mind-blowing, okay? I've not had a single one that faded. Not a single one. And they just work so well in your soaps. And if you're a candle maker, you can go over there and get all your candle making needs. If you make bath bombs, get all your ingredients for your bath bomb. You can get your colorants. They have a crafting library for those of you who are starting and want to learn how to, say, melt and pour, how to do that, how to make handmade soap. I mean, Rustic Essentials is your one-stop shopping. Just everything you need to know, you can find it right there. Now, I did tell you guys that I was going to tell you something at the end of the video. So what I am going to do, number one, you need to go over to Rustic Essentials and you need to sign up for their newsletter and their blog, because they always have just great, great information over there. And I mean, you most definitely want to, If you're not on their email list, what in the halibut are you waiting on? Get over there and sign up for their emails, most definitely. Yeah, be sure to do that. You don't want to miss out on anything that Rustic Essential has to offer. So be sure you sign up for their newsletter as well. So I wanted to pull this up. Hopefully it's not too much of a crazy glare. So Rustic Essentials is, yeah, that's like kind of, maybe I can bring it closer. Yeah. Okay, so they are having a autumn fragrance oil giveaway. And I think like the script on here is kind of wonky. That's normally what happens when you hold a phone up to a camera. I think I just improved it. So here it says 5 individual winners will receive 25. You hear that? 25 1-ounce bottles of brand new autumn fragrances, which are some of these guys. It's coming to the website soon. They retail it. It's a retail value of $62.25, a rafflecopter giveaway. So I'm going to put that link right there in the section below, and you can go over there. Oh, and my phone said I'm done. But yeah, you want to go over there, and you want to sign up, and you want to be able to get into their newsletter. Excuse me, sir, hold on. Get their newsletter and get in this raffle. Hello. I mean, all this fabulousness that I've just been telling you guys about, you get to have, you hear me? 25 bottles, which is all of the, I mean, it's all of them. Yeah, it's all of them. So you get to have them all, and you most definitely want to get in that. So I'm going to leave all that information below. Go over there. Be sure that you sign up. And if you are already signed up, which I don't know why you weren't, you need to get in that giveaway so you can get all of these puppies. They're 2016 fall winter holiday fragrances. You will not be disappointed. You will be so happy that you did, guys. Most definitely. So again, I want to give a big fat warm fluffy hug to everyone at Rustic Essentials. Amy, you are the bee's knees, honey. The cat's pajamas. Yes, you are, and you rock my stripy socks. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for always just spoiling me to death, y'all. Y'all just do love you. I sure do. And I thank you all for stopping by my channel every time I post a video. If you are not a subscriber, please do hit that subscribe button. Matter of fact, just go ahead and hit it right now. That way you'll be up to date of when I post videos like this, when I'm doing soul making videos, every time I post a video. And also for those of you who are not getting notifications, who are subscribers, go into your settings on YouTube and check your settings to make sure that your notifications are turned on. Okay? You need to give a big old fat thumbs up for this review, because you guys, I'm telling you, they are just blowing me out the water with these fragrances. I am so excited about all of them. You guys need to get some. The way that you can get some is going over to Rustic Essentials, signing up, getting in that giveaway, and get all of these fragrances for free. You're gonna win them, but you can't win unless you get in, right? All right, guys, that's it. Love, hugs, and kisses. Be awesome and amazing, that everything and everything you do, not that. And remember, I love you. And until next time, I'll see you later. Bye.